Sometimes I think I'm happy here. Sometimes, yeah, I still pretend. I can't remember how this got started. Oh, but I can tell you exactly how it will end. Every day is exactly the same. There is no love here, and there is no pain. Every day is exactly the same. I've been doing this YouTube job for over 6 years now. I've learned a lot, changed a lot, over the years. And YouTube itself has changed considerably. Not just the website, but the mentality of the viewership, the things that people value, the things that I value in turn as a creator. I've always been somebody who likes to switch things up based on what I'm feeling inspired to do. I don't want to just tie myself to one type of content, one type of series. I'm always looking for something that represents what I'm feeling at the moment. And the tastes of the YouTube audience have changed considerably over time. When I started in this career, if you were making a video longer than 3 minutes, you really had to pour your heart and soul into it if you wanted it to succeed. If you wanted to have a video that was a 20-minute analysis, if it didn't have a certain level of editing and polish, and it wasn't really exciting, it wasn't going to get any views. In fact, getting views on a video over 10 minutes was considerably difficult at all. Nowadays, if you put out a 3-minute video, people will just be like, it's only 3 minutes? What's the point? I want to watch endless YouTube. I want you to put out 2.5 hours of you just talking into a camera if it means it'll fill more time in my day. But there are also a lot of people who are starved for a higher level of quality from their content. People who want something that clearly comes from the soul, that has imagination put into it, that packs as much as it can into every moment. Around this time last year, I took a lot of major risks. I was trying to change up my content in a way that would be closer to what I was seeking from YouTube videos and what I thought there was a large subset of people who were secretly craving. People wanted something that no one was providing on the platform, and I hoped to accomplish it. A lot of what I was striving to do, though, I thought was misguided, and it was based on an idea I had in the back of my mind from years prior about what I thought the ultimate Digibro career would look like, about what I thought would be the idealized form of the Digibro channel, and what I thought, like, I'd kind of hoped to get to all these years. But when I made the Gecko Estate vlogs last year, I realized that my priorities were in the wrong place. That what I thought I wanted from my YouTube career was largely based on what I used to admire, what I thought I was going to be doing eventually, and not on what made sense currently, not only for the audience, but also for myself. What was actually a natural extension of my voice and style? What would make sense as the final form of Digibro content? Over the last year, I've had tons of time to meditate, tons of time to look at what works and what doesn't work, even harder than I ever had before, to really reassess my career and think about what I want out of it and what will work. I've been waiting to enter a new renaissance, and for a long time I've just been brooding because I was stuck back in my place at Boston. If you've seen my video about the unabridged story of Boston, you know pretty much what went down, and it was just like being in a stasis pretty much from winter up until I was able to move. Just feeling like nothing was going to be able to truly begin until I had moved to a new place and really gotten my life sorted out, put myself into a more comfortable situation where I felt like I was ready to start from a really firm base and branch off from there and make everything work. And because I knew that this time was coming, it was like biding my time over the last 6 months, just doing whatever I could to both keep myself afloat and to just entertain myself. Stuff like I Am Games, which I put a lot of emphasis on over the last 6 months, was because that was something I could do for fun and passion and as an experiment to just try out all these different styles of release to see if I could launch a channel, you know, from nothing and base it on the paradigms that already existed. But at the end of the day, what I am best at, and have always been best at, is creating new paradigms. Not just doing what everybody else is doing or what seems to make sense, but creating something that is wholly mine, something totally unique. When I started making anime analysis videos, it was not something a lot of people were doing. Much like when I first began with My Little Pony analysis videos, I was the only person doing something that you would consider an analytical review, and in my wake there were left literally hundreds of channels that were doing the same type of thing. Once I got into anime, I saw lots of review channels, some stuff that maybe included a little bit more analytical thought, but in my wake, there was a huge rise in directly analytical content that spiraled out way beyond just people who watched me. You know, I influenced people who influenced people, and now it is a thriving part of YouTube culture. But there's a lot more that we could be doing. There's a lot more that I have been able to think of content styles, video styles that would interest me. You can find little sprinkles of what I've been experimenting with. Stuff like the Otaku Gonzo Journal Episode 1, a very new feeling type of video that's not quite like anything that anybody's done before, even if it is still in the same wheelhouse. I don't want to scare anybody here. I'm not about to radically change everything that DigiBro is. I'm not about to suddenly make videos that don't resemble something you want. In fact, more likely I'm going to start making videos that are more what you've wanted from me than you or I could have known up to this point. For the past week, I've just been setting up my new house, building some crazy sets. I still have a lot more work to do, and I want to build all kinds of shit that I already have the means to do. I can already create lots of unique things that I want to do. But it's going to take a little bit more setup time. I don't want to give myself too much time, though, because I'm really excited to take you all with me and get you into the headspace of where I'm at right now as a creator. I've got three more of the Let's Argue videos that you have probably all seen on the main channel. These videos were edited by the Devu, and after the last one, the Devu will no longer be working for me as an editor. He's done incredible work for me for years. I've absolutely loved having him as an editor, but we've come to a place now where not only do I want to do my own editing because I want to base the type of videos I make around the kind of editing that I would do, but also because Devu is trying to move on with his life and do other things. He's become a game developer. If you haven't played his game Autonomous, he's going to advertise it in the final episode of Let's Argue, but you can also find it on thedevu.com. If you want to follow what goes on with him over the years as a creator, that would be the place to look. I'm planning to release the last three episodes of Let's Argue, one a day for 3 days in a row, and then right after that's over, we're launching into the new era. You may have noticed that some of the iconography on my channels and Twitter and on Patreon has already shifted. I'm going to be updating a lot of the text on those places, just redefining the identity of all of my work to complement what's going to come. I'm not changing any of the Patreon rewards or anything. I'm very happy with the structure of how all that is set up right now. But there will be some shifting in the type of content that you're going to see on both of my channels. A lot of what would traditionally be considered After Dark content is probably going to get worked into the main channel. I'm just going to update the aesthetics of a lot of these videos, maybe put a little bit more thought and craft into some stuff that might have just come as a simple vlog before, and try to work it over there. And what happens on the After Dark channel will be more focused on videos that are just very straightforward and to the point. Stuff like the rant hole obviously is going to stay here, and just anything that I don't think would make it on the main channel. But what is going to happen on the main channel will be vastly broader than it has been up to this point. Now, there were times in DigiBro's history that the channel was not just about anime, that I was talking about video games, that I would occasionally vlog about, like, social constructs and stuff like that, and I want it to be more like that again. When I made the shift, basically last August, I decided that because the channel was best known as an anime channel, I would try to focus more on that element as a way of growing it further. And this was born out of the desperation I had when I lived at the last place to make more money. Being in a situation where I felt like I wasn't making enough and I was trapped in a year-long lease, you know. So I just felt like I had to pour everything into making as much money as possible. And the ways that I ended up making more money were not really the ways that I thought it would happen. It wasn't connected to the type of content I was making, really, at all. It had more to do with my narrative, how people were getting involved with it, and how I evolved my Patreon. These were the elements that really pumped up the amount of money I was able to make, almost nothing to do with the type of content I was producing. So that's why I'm abandoning the idea of DigiBro just being an anime channel or just being, you know, focused on this one element. I want it to be about whatever I want it to be about. It's just going to be whatever I have an idea for a video for in the same style, not necessarily the exact same style that you're used to, but something in proximity to it is going to be on there. Obviously still tons of anime shit since that's most of what I care about, but you know, if I'm gonna talk about, say, do an album review, or if I'm gonna talk about something to do with a social construct that would be interesting to tackle in a certain way and with editing, you know, instead of just as a vlog, it might go on there. I'm extremely excited about what's to come, and I hope you will be too. Get ready. Countdown. 4 days. Till everything changes.